Hello, my friends. Kosho here at the Lion's Den. And the first thing I want to say is that it's hot as balls in here. It's like 100 degrees outside. So I'm inside my office where the sun comes right in. So it's got to be 100 plus degrees inside. So I will be sweating during this video where we talk about cutting. Yeah, so get your chainsaws ready. Because it's time to go over how to cut. It's summer, let's shred and give you guys some tips to be a freaking beast. All right, guys, like I said in the intro, we're gonna be talking all about cutting, okay? So that is losing weight, getting shredded, diced, and sliced up. It's summertime, okay? I'm cutting, so I'm gonna go through everything you need to know to get your cutting plan set and ready to be executed, okay? Last time we were doing the whiteboard talk, I was actually massing. So if you're wondering how to mass or what I've done to mass, I'll put the link right up here. I'm actually 20 pounds down, have about 5 weeks left out of this 15-week cut. So I'm gonna break it down step by step, what I have done personally. You guys can do with that information what you will. Maybe it's a base for you, maybe you don't relate to it, that's fine, but all I know is kind of what I've done for myself. So I'm gonna share with you guys, all right? So today is gonna be very basic for this video, and then the next video we're gonna dive in a little bit deeper, answer some more of the nuance, questions, and give you guys more of an outline with some more detail. But just to start, okay, why would we cut? All right, so there's a couple of reasons why you would cut, and obviously the first one is just to lose fat. Now, you can be doing different phases. So there's massing phases, maintenance phases, and cutting phases. And typically after you've done some sort of massing phase, maybe you've maintained that mass for a good amount of time, and then for whatever reason you wanna cut, okay, you can head into that cutting phase. But if you aren't doing any of those phases and maybe you're just somebody who wants to lose weight, that's a fine reason too, okay? Maybe you are just unhealthy and you wanna just get your health metrics better. So cutting may be a great way to do that. Obviously, we have a huge problem with obesity and I handle a lot of overweight clients. And one of the best things we can do is just get them to a healthy weight. And usually that clears up a lot of the health problems. So it just depends on what kind of category you're falling in. But mainly we're cutting because we wanna lose weight or we wanna increase our health in general, or we kinda just wanna see what's under the hood, quote unquote, after we've done a massing phase and kinda, you know, let those muscles stand out and pop a little bit. Obviously, the next one will be looking good. Okay, it's summertime. Typically, I like to align my training seasonally. So in the winter, that's when I'm gonna spend a lot of time massing. Obviously, it's cold, we're wearing sweatshirts, you know, whatever. But in the summertime, maybe you're hanging out at the pool, maybe you go to the beach, or you go for hikes, you're outdoors more. The sun's gonna be out, it's gonna be warmer. So typically, we're gonna be exposing ourselves more, and we kinda wanna show off the hard work that we've put in throughout the winter time. So looking good is fantastic. Then the last one, there's two that kind of fall in line with this, but that's going to be sports specific. So maybe you have a weight class. So like myself, okay, in a few months, I have to weigh in under 231, okay, for the strongman games, okay? So I have to be a 105 strongman. And when I started this journey, I was about 270. So to cut from 270 all the way down to 231 when I weigh in, that's a very huge cut, okay? We're talking, you know, 30, 40 pounds, give or take. So for me, I progressively cut down to about 245, 250-ish. So then I can do a quick water cut, make weight, and then put that weight back on. So that's kind of the case for something sports specific, or if you're just trying to hit a weight class that you wanna stay at, okay, maybe you're gonna lose weight to get there. The other thing could be for bodybuilding, okay? Maybe you're in the sport of bodybuilding or some sort of physique competition, you need to lose weight. So that would be the reason why. And I know it sounds basic, but sometimes we don't know why we're doing things, okay? Or maybe you're new to the channel or new to this journey, and it's just good to understand why people cut, and maybe now you know. So moving on to the second point, we have how to cut, okay? So the first thing right off the bat when it comes to any goal, Okay, this could be for strength training. This could be for nutrition. This could be for building a business. Just really any goal in life, we need to have some sort of timeline, okay? And this doesn't always mean this is the exact deadline, unless maybe it is for a competition, you know. But it's good to have some sort of start and end point. All right, so like I said in the beginning, I've been doing a 15-week cut. Okay, so that's 15 weeks where I progressively have been adjusting my calories, my activity level, et cetera, to get to where I'm at today. So for you, I would like you guys to put down on your goals or your paper what that timeline is, and you wanna make sure that you give yourself enough time. So for me, I always feel like a good prep period has to be 12 weeks or more. All right, anything kind of under 12 weeks becomes tough to really make substantial gains and then peak. All right, so for you guys, I think anywhere in that 12 to 15 week window is gonna be fantastic for some sort of cutting phase. It's gonna give you a lot of time to collect data and make the adjustments nice and steady when we're progressing through this, okay? Because if I said, okay, you have 4 weeks to get as diced up as possible, well, chances are it's probably not gonna be done as healthy as possible. It's gonna be very drastic, and then you're probably gonna rebound and almost just kind of mess up all the progress that we made. So, setting up that timeline is gonna be crucial for you to have the best results possible. So like I said, we wanna be in that 12 to 15 week window. Heck, if you wanna push it out to 20, that's fine too. But as long as you have the structure, that's like the key ingredient, because a lot of people, they pick goals and then they don't set themselves a timeline and they kind of just get lost where they feel like they can keep pushing it and pushing it and pushing it. Well, guess what? You know, then time will just continue on. Maybe you don't get results or you don't make any changes. So stick to that timeline the best you can, and give yourself enough time. So when it comes to cutting, specifically, it's gonna have a lot to do with calories, okay? And we've talked about these different phases, right? So we have our maintenance phase, which just means whatever amount of calories you need to eat to maintain the weight that you're at. So if I'm 245 pounds and it takes 3,500 calories to maintain 245 pounds, that would be my maintenance base of calories. So if I go above those calories, right, we're in what we call a surplus, then over time, I would start to gain weight or gain mass. Okay, so typically when we're massing, we wanna be in that surplus over maintenance level. And then when we're cutting, we wanna be in a deficit. So we wanna be below maintenance, and over time we'll lose weight. So technically, say if it was 3,500 calories for maintenance and I just dropped 200 calories, it may not be very fast, but over time I would progressively lose weight, okay? So the second biggest tip when it comes to cutting, guys, is you have to find your maintenance calorie level. And the only way to do that is to track your food. You cannot do any sort of dieting, whether that's the maintenance, the massing, or the cutting, without understanding and tracking your food and where your calories are at, okay? It comes down to calories, right? When everyone says, you know, it's all calories in, calories out, and that is true. There are some nuances that you can get involved with, but for the most part, understanding where your caloric intake is gonna be key. And you have to track that. So you can use whatever app you wanna use. There's MyFitnessPal, there's Chronometer, the RP Diet app does all of this stuff for you. And all you have to do is just track for a couple days, get the average of where you're at, and start that as your maintenance phase. And then what you do is you'll just subtract calories from that and put yourself in a deficit. Now, I always recommend being in a 300 to 500 calorie deficit to start. If you're new to it, maybe start at 300 and just see how your body responds to that. If you're getting good weight loss after a couple weeks, just keep it where it's at. If it's not broken, we don't have to fix it, right? And then maybe you hit a stalling point, that's when we can reduce the calories a little bit more, okay? And that's kind of what you guys really need to understand, is finding that maintenance calorie. And just gonna say one more time, you have to track, okay? If you're not tracking, it's not gonna happen, okay? And once you develop that habit, it becomes very easy, and it's just data that you can collect, and you really get to understand how your body works, and then you can make all the decisions and the choices that you need to make to get to your goal. So last point, like I said, was creating that deficit. We wanna be in that 300 to 500 deficit. And that's basically the layout of you know, why we cut and how we cut. There's gonna be some extra things I'm gonna talk about on the next portion of the board where it has to do with programming and cardio. And then we'll see kind of where this video is at, because I'm gonna do a couple parts of this. And after that, you guys should be all set and ready to rock and roll. Okay guys, so without keeping this video super long, I just wanna dive into a couple extra points to piggyback off what we had just talked about. And that is gonna be programming and cardio. So a question I get asked all the time is, what sort of program should I be on when I'm cutting? And to be honest with you, if you, whatever program you're doing, and if you're reducing your calories properly, you should be losing weight, okay? If the goal is just weight loss, all right, then you should be losing weight. You can stay on the same program. Now, for those of you that wanna maintain as much muscle as possible, and you put in a lot of work in the off season, this isn't gonna be like life or death changing, but it does make a little bit of a difference, and that is having a program that has higher volume, okay? So doing more reps. So if you guys watch my training during this cut, or you purchase my hypertrophy program, which is on Szatstrength.net, it is going to be a higher volume program, typically where we're not doing anything less than reps of 5. So you're gonna be doing anywhere from 5 to 20 reps, okay? Because while we're in that deficit, our main purpose, at least when I cut, is gonna be to preserve and maintain as much muscle as I can. We're trying to fight the breakdown of the muscle, and higher volume training tends to be shown to do that in the research. So higher volume would be the route that I would take, and also higher frequency. Okay, so I train 5 to 6 days a week when I'm doing my hypertrophy work and I'm in my cut. And typically on the flip side, when I'm doing my strength training, maybe I train 4 to 5 days per week, and those reps could be anywhere from 1 to 10. But when we're doing the higher volume, okay, like I said, we're not gonna drop anywhere below 5 reps. So that's gonna be optimal if you guys are looking to also, on top of losing weight, is maintain as much muscle as possible. So it really depends on the goals that you have and how much you care about preserving that muscle. But that's just my thoughts on programming. Now, when it comes to cardio, so I was under the belief growing up that you had to be doing tons of cardio, like 1 to 1.5 hours on the Stairmaster or the treadmill while you were cutting. But what, you know, we have found from the evidence that presents the best looking physiques, especially, you know, in physique competitors, is to really manipulate the weight loss by nutrition and not to overdo it on the cardio, and kind of keep the cardio basically to a minimum. Now, obviously, if you want to work on your heart health and being healthy, you know, throw that in as you would like to, but when we want to look the best we can and preserve as much muscle, keeping that cardio as little as we need to is going to be optimal. And a nice way that I've done this with my personal cut has been just by tracking steps, okay? And basically, when I had this 15-week cut, I just said I have to minimally have 10,000 steps a day. So if I went over, awesome, and if I didn't go over that, I'd either, one, make sure that I did by the end of the day, or it would kind of roll over to the next day, so that if I looked at the week, it averaged out to be 10,000 steps per day, which is just a nice place to start. And you can play with that a little bit, but I'd say the minimum should be 10,000 for you guys. And I just did that with walking. So I didn't do tons of hardcore cardio and conditioning. And when I was doing that, I felt like, one, I was actually a lot more hungry and my satiation was like not there. So it made me want to eat more. And by doing just steps or walking, okay, it's going to be a little bit lower impact on the joints. It's not gonna be as taxing. You're not gonna have these crazy hunger pains or anything like that. And it's still also keeping us relatively healthy, okay? So you can walk your way to a great physique. So that's what I did. And like I said, this is my personal take on this. You guys can make it work for you. But from talking to a lot of the professionals in the physique competitive world, the new thing is to not push cardio as hard, manipulate the most by calorie restriction. And that's kind of where they're at. And that's kind of the last point I said, is just minimal is going to be best for muscle retention. So that's kind of it, guys, when it comes to the basics of cutting. Now, in the next video, I'm going to be talking more specific on my macros, how it's broken up, kind of where I started for the first several weeks and kind of the phases I went through, and then kind of how I'm going to wrap this thing up. And you guys can use that as a base for you, and then go from there. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for the next one, and make sure you guys are liking the video, subscribe to the channel, and share this with your friends and family. It means the world to me. We also have a Facebook group, The Iron Lions. So just type it in the Facebook search bar, The Iron Lions. Ask to join the group, we'll accept you. We do form checks, there's articles, just a cool hub for everybody who's into lifting, nutrition, you know, all that kind of good stuff. Just a place for you to feel welcome. So we'd love to have you guys. And as always, stay a lean, mean strength machine. Peace.